And you're gonna be thrown to power. Goes back to the very beginning, to a precious old lady named Lily Burton, and we call her Mimi, and Great Mimi actually, because she's my great grandmother, and she lives out on a farm in the middle of town. Of course, there wasn't a town when she first moved there, and I'm glad that I've gotten to sing this song to her while she's still alive. I don't think she's ever heard me. She's kind of, But someday I'm going to sing this song to her in heaven, and she's going to go, is that what you were doing in front of me all those years? Anyway. I remember many times when I was just a child, how I played in that old house out on the farm, with rocking chairs and squeaky stairs, all pieces of her world, and a fire in her room to keep us warm. 'Cause no one is a stranger in Mimi's house, 'cause love has made his home there in her heart. And she's got that infectious way of laughing right out loud that takes away my pain and lights the dark. And now I'm not as young as when I played there all the time, and the visits seem too scarce and far between. But life goes on at Mimi's house, and in my mind I'm there, with a fire in her room to keep us warm. Cause no one is a stranger in Mimi's house. Cause love has made his home there in her heart. And she's got that infectious way of laughing right out loud that takes away my pain and lights the dark. And when I stop and think of how she's aging, growing strong and graceful in her God, well, you know it takes my fear away from aging. She seems to know the secret that we'll never be apart. Cause no one is a stranger in Mimi's house. Cause love has made his home there in her heart. And she's got that infectious way of laughing right out loud that takes away my pain and lights the dark. Yes, she's got that infectious way of laughing right out loud that takes away my pain and lights the dark.
I heard a song about 2.5 years ago. Remember the first time I heard it, I cried all the way through it because somehow it said everything that I'd always wanted to say better than I could ever say it. And so this song has become a prayer for me, and I hope tonight it's a prayer for you.
For her little girl, my face may not grace the mind of everyone in the world, but that's all right. As long as I can have one wish, I pray. When people look inside my life, I wanna hear them say, she has her father's eyes, her father's eyes, eyes that find the good in things when good is not around, and eyes that find the source of help when help just can't be found, and eyes compassion, seeing every pain, knowing what you're going through and feeling it the same, just like my father's eyes, my father's eyes, my father's eyes. Her father's eyes, eyes that found the good in things when good was not around, and eyes that found the source of help when help would not be found, and eyes full of compassion, seeing same, just like my father's eyes. My father's eyes. My father's eyes. You know, just like my father's eyes. My father's eyes. My father's eyes, you know, just like my father's eyes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
this one. Sing along.
I love to sing and I love to pray. Worship the Lord most every day. I go to the temple and I just want to stay. Tired from the hustle of the world and its ways. And I'd love to live on a mountaintop, fellowshipping with the Lord. I'd love to stand on a mountaintop, 'cause I love to feel my spirit soar. But I've got to come down from the mountaintop to the people in the valley below. They'll never know that they can go to the mountain of the Lord. Now praising the Father is a good thing to do, to worship the Trinity in spirit and truth. But if we worshiped all of the time, well, there would be no one to lead the blind. But I'd love to live on a mountaintop, just fellowshipping with the Lord. And I'd love to stand on a mountaintop, 'cause I love to feel my spirit soar. But I've got to come down from the mountaintop to the people in the valley below. Of the Lord. Now this is the most important verse for me, maybe you. I am not saying that worship is wrong, but worship is more than just singing some songs. 'Cause it's all that we say and everything that we do, it's letting God's Spirit live through you. Still I'd love to worshiping with the Lord. I'd love to stand on a mountaintop, 'cause I love to feel my spirit soar. But I've got to come down from the mountaintop to the people in the valley below. They'll never know that they can go to the mountain of the Lord.
Thank you. A fellow by the name of Gary Chapman had written a song that I'd said, oh yeah, I really want that to be on my album. But it wasn't until we cut all the lights out and I started singing it to that quiet guitar that something inside broke, and I realized all I have to be, Lord Jesus, is what you have made me to be.
Resting heavy on my head, and the thoughtful words of help and hope have all been nicely said. But I'm still hurting, wondering if I'll ever be try to be the
best. The more I get, the worst. And I realize the good in me is only there because of who you are. Who you are. And all I ever have to be is what you've made me. Any more or less would be a step out of your plan. As you daily recreate me, help me always keep in mind that I only have to do what I can find. And all I ever have to be, all I have to be, all I ever have to be is what you've made.
That's all we ask tonight. That's it. Just get a vision for who he wants you to be. As a 15-year-old, the first time I ever wrote a little song, dinky little song, it was called Mountain Man. I remember singing it for my mom the first time. I remember at that point she said, "I don't think music is your gift, Dame." And I went upstairs and I put my guitar down, and about 2 weeks later I wrote a song. It starts off, "When I think of all the things he's doing for me, it makes me stand and wonder at what he's making me to be. Trying to walk through straight but getting turned around. I'm always making my master take a back seat and wait around. But I praise the Lord for giving me a brand new start each day. And I praise his blessed name for guiding me all along the way. For if he didn't, I wouldn't even try." Out of the mouth of babes. Sometimes I look back at that 15-year-old girl and think, whew. Please teach me what you knew back then. Things are different now. Spend a lot more time on the road, and life is not quite as simple. I used to sing all my songs to our two old poodles on the back steps. And now I'm singing to you. No comparison, huh? You're not dogs, but Mom sold the poodles to the painter, so I took to the road. We got a new song for you called Singing a Love Song.
Well, I may not get applause every night when I sing, and I may not hear the cheers of a crowd, and my voice can't always rise to make the mountains ring, and at times I can't even sing out loud. But you've got me singing a love song, melody and rhyme. It moves me every time. You've got me singing a love song, and it keeps you on my mind. Ooh, on my mind. Feeling fine all the time. It keeps you on my mind. Sometimes my voice is strained and the strings won't hold a tune. My back is sore and I'm just too tired to try. And I don't want to work or rest or think of you or face the world or even close my eyes.
you've got me singing a love song, melody and rhyme. It moves me every time. I know that you've got me singing a love song, and it keeps you on my mind, ooh, on my mind, feeling fine all the time. It keeps you on my mind. My broken dreams, they don't bother me. And hard times in life, I don't mind. I think of things that I'd rather see, and you give me peace of to hear me in the silence of my song. I'm gonna sing for you until the end of time. 'Cause you've got me singing a love song, melody and rhyme. It moves me every time. You've got me singing a love song, and it keeps you on my mind.
Father of lies.
Are you walking with the necessary burdens? Are you trying to take them upon yourself? If you are, then you're living in bondage, and you know that's bad for your spiritual health. And are you trying to live by your emotions? Are you putting your faith in what you feel and see? Then you're living just to satisfy your passions, but you better be careful.
Are you living in an old man's rubble? Are you listening to the father of lies? If you are, then you're headed for trouble. If you listen too long, you'll eventually die. Are you living in an old man's rubble? Are you listening to the father of lies? If you are, then you're headed for trouble. If you listen too long, you'll eventually die.
Are you puzzled by the way that you behave? Do you wonder why you do the things you do? And are you troubled by your lack of resistance? Do you feel that something's got a hold on you? Deep within you there's a spiritual battle. There's a voice of the darkness, a voice of the light. And just by listening we made our decision, 'cause the voice we hear is gonna win the fight.
Are you living in an old man's rubble? Are you listening to the Father?
And you're gonna be